Please. This is MSN 4, powered by 4, into the large sweeping 7,000, each building, now about 70,000 pounds plus. As the Airbus A-400M starts to spin the plane, drop the left. Over 1,600 engines on order, worth something like £30 billion on order. Actually, one of those who stand the same, but the loss of size of the engines is only 350. Customers. That was the end of last month. And by the end of last month, Airbus had delivered a total of 27 of this type, the A350-900. And indeed, on the very first day of Farnborough, Sir Richard Branson was here and confirmed the order of the A350-1000 and ordered 8 of that aircraft to replace the fleet of 747-400s. That Virgin Atlantic News. One type to another. That is really dependent on the airline operator and the civil aviation in that country to which that airline operates. 350 coming around back towards us. Normally not I fly A350 on Popcorn Island. I asked you that, I guess you still got an answer. So now letting the 380 go back into its roost, the A400 on the north side, waiting his turn to display. The Dark 450 and drop 178 the Dornier 328 and 787, 727, 73 and the PA. Future large aircraft requirement way back in 1992, supported by nations of Belgium, France, Germany, Italy, Portugal, Spain, and Turkey. The beginning of the creation of it was in Germany, January 05, and now very much into service. In fact, we saw it first here at Farnborough in 2010. By November last year, the order book largest customers in Germany and France, with orders of 53 and 50 aircraft respectively. Here in the UK, we have ordered 22 A400Ms, the first delivery taking place in November 14. Estimated the export market over the next 25 years will account for something like 400 of these types of airlifters. So the first style side stick controls by the wire, adapted to emission profiles.
Centerline seats, stick it in the medevac roll, in the medical roll, the time to carry 66 stretchers with 35 medical staff. Gives it great flexibility there. You can see clearly the in-flight refueling mode. That's that scaffolding bowl effectively ahead of the cockpit. Cruising anywhere between 300 and 350 miles an hour, something in that sort of area. Flexible for airdrop operations, able to conduct at anywhere between 125 and 200 knots, depends on whether you can put you in to get away from your seat to which you're dropping supplies, or if you're very quick, you're doing good, out the back door, you lock the parachute out the back, and all that goes straight up the back of the hook. Watch out on the ground. Those propellers, very interesting, 8-bladed composite curved propellers. Each adjacent propeller on each wing, we're taking opposite directions. They produce down between the engines airflow. Told you the benefits are reduced wing loading, more symmetrical airflow, that helps, greater lift distribution, and very much improved engine output. Up to 90 degrees angle bank, it's not loaded in one. Carbon ceramic brakes, you're going to see those used. A very short landing run capable of this aircraft. Because after being into rough, unprepared strips, you might not have the luxury of having a patient turn around and go and have another takeoff run. So you land, you reverse back down the strip, dump the troops or the kit, and then take off straight away, and the next one comes in to land. And be rugged and tough on that. The gear actually could be inflated or deflated just to help unloading and loading of equipment on the rear ramp area. Like a Citroën DS. There you go. I think it's more really comfortable. But they're great cars. Great fun cars. The operating flight deck crew of two, NVG capable, nitrogen goggle capability, head up display. You can also have four faces stationed out the tactical commander, mission commander to be accommodated if that's what your operation is. You are here to see the efficiency of those 8-bladed composite props going into full reverse thrust, the brakes going on just after landing. Indeed, at full reverse pitch, these props can reverse the aircraft up a 2-degree concrete slope at maximum takeoff weight. Atlas on the approach, just waiting for the 350 to move. We may even get a little extra flypass. We've got plenty of time to play with, so we might get a flyby, which would be good news. downwind to land. Those of you who have noticed, we're not looking at weather. I'm looking at the rain to the north of us. Because we've got something like 10 minutes before our next item to fly, as a 18 Super Hornet. So that could be drifting to the north of us. Hope the Super Hornet will get the full altitude as the A400 comes in at us from the ground. Very short landing. We haven't yet seen the full display of the Hornet. On day one, we actually didn't see it because the Hornet's rain was so heavy. We took out from the runway and just faded from view from us.